Yeah, well, our reporter Shadrach Miti has been following this report. We'll be joining him a bit later, but first, I understand Shadrach Miti is ready for us. Let's speak to Shadrach Miti. As you were detailing there earlier, Shadrach, quite a reprieve for diploma holders. What more benefits does this come with?
Well, the biggest benefit, Michelle, is that in this new system or the ages that the government is setting up will be to ensure that every academic journey or history of any individual, particularly from a mid-level up to the university and any other academic ventures that one desires to venture in, must have a particular history. And therefore, what the Kenya National Qualification Authority is seeking to do is, besides ensuring that there shall be no what the cabinet secretary was saying, qualifications that are full of questionable credentials, qualifications that purport to have come from institutions that are not even accredited by the government, this particular move aims at ensuring that every other information that an individual has regarding their academic journey, right from the primary to high school to the college and up to the university, is well traced and can be tracked from a particular point. And therefore, there are about three issues that the Kenya National Qualification Authority is revolving around. But two of them are that when one comes out and says that I'm qualified in this particular field, then that qualification has to be centered through, has to be centered around a clearly structured framework that is well accredited and well qualified as per the institutions that have been set up by the government to ensure that any accreditation that comes up or any institution that comes up to give any training in whatsoever field, that same institution has to be accredited by government, and the information there too has to be available to all. That you will not be doing guesswork to look for any institution to go to. And another thing, Michelle, is that remember what we have been experiencing up to this time, before maybe the government came in to intervene, was that you find someone has gone to a mid-level college to train in a particular field and comes out with a diploma in that same field. But the unfortunate aspect over the same is that when someone wants to transit to the university, the same has to begin just like any other person who is coming from Form 4. And so what the government is seeking, besides outlining and streamlining all this process, it's also ensuring that there is much credence, there is much genuineness in any diploma that is acquired from any given mid-level college, so that when one wishes to transit to the university, then that aspect of credit transfer shall be considered highly. And so those are some of the larger benefits that we are still expecting over the same. But and another thing is that, Michelle, what also the government will be seeking through this new qualification authority is to ensure that, remember, we have been having a situation where people go out, study, and when they come up to present those papers have had a lot of issues. And so besides just looking at the smooth transition of training in colleges, this particular authority will also be addressing the issue of foreign examinations, foreign qualifications, insofar as our local academic standards are concerned. Back to you, Michelle. There is a